Okay, what we're going to go through in this video are some very unusual, very challenging break ball situations that you'll find in the game of straight pool. As you can see by the shots that I've just shown in the pictures, some of these are going to be hard, some of them are rather simple if you know what to do. In this shot here, I'm a little further away from the rack than I want to be, but look at my cue ball. And one of the things that I was taught very early on when I was learning how to play the game is that you don't want your cue ball to get beat up on the break shot. And generally, if you watch the way I control my cue ball through the shot, I try to contact one ball in the stack, and that's it. And right there, I made solid contact with the rack. The ball spread very, very well. You could kind of say that I killed the ball. I didn't really hit a dead spot. I hit that top corner ball. This second shot comes up all the time if you get out of position like I do. And right there, a little bit of bottom English on the inside kind of pulls the ball right into that corner ball. When you hit the corners, you have a better chance of having the rack disperse. And you're going to see me, I'm going to hit on the bottom. That pulls the cue ball into the rack. I hit that corner ball, the eight ball. And as you can see, my cue ball is free. I've got a variety of different shots that I can start to start clearing the rack there. Here's an example of what not to do. Here I've got a very unusual break ball with the ball against the rail. And look at that. Boom. I hit what you call the death triangle. That's what us straight pool players like to call it. Watch what my cue ball does here when it comes off of the rail. You can see I put a little bit too much follow on it, and the ball kind of torqued. And that's, like I said, that's what us straight pool players call that death triangle. It's why you never want to go into the side of the stack. You always want to go into the corners. The corners are going to disperse the rack, and your cue ball is likely to get free. Here's another version of the same shot. This is similar, and this time, look at the result. This time I hit the ball, I believe that's a 15. I hit it up on the top this time, and watch. Bang. My cue ball just kind of deflects off of there. And all I need is a little window to get on that ball that just came off the rail. And it's a pretty good shot, requires a lot of control. Believe it or not, I get this shot all the time. If you watch, it's just straight follow as one, two rails, straight into the top two balls. Pick one, just try not to hit the gap. There, I hit that corner. The balls disperse. That back corner ball comes off of the rail and back out for my first shot. So even though these are a little unorthodox, you don't see them all the time, it's a good thing to practice these when they come up. If you watch this break shot here, you see the way I set, and watch my cue ball. Boom. I hit one ball and I get my cue ball free. I don't want the balls to control my cue ball by knocking it around the table. If you watch how I set into my shot here I'm gonna find the contact point of what I'm gonna do with my aiming. I put my stick down and boom, I'm zoning in on not only where I'm hitting the object ball to make it, I've also got to pick a point in the rack of where I want my cue ball to go. And you see me zoning in, I take a second, and when I pick both points, I pull my cue back, and control is the most important factor right there. My cue ball hit one ball, popped a little bit of follow on that shot, came down to that bottom rail, and back out to get another shot. Like I said, if you rely on your cue ball just smashing into the rack, having other balls hit it and not getting it out of the way, means the difference between getting another shot or ending up in one of the pockets with your cue ball, and you don't want to do that. Here's another shot. See me set, get down, I aim, and boom. I hit one ball in the stack, come back out, just tap that ball, that straight ball on the rail a little bit. But you look at me, I'm looking at my aim point on the object ball. I'm setting. And as I'm setting, I'm looking at the point on the rack that I want my cue ball to go to. I get down into my stance, and right there, I'm zoning in. All I want is control of that cue ball. And when I pull back, my cue ball hits that one ball. A little bit of hop right there. Never hurt nobody. And there, that strike ball comes off the rail. Just a little tap of my cue ball, not enough to move it anywhere. And if you look at the balls, none of them are touching. They're all wide open. Got a couple of break ball candidates. And, you know, what else could you ask for from a break shot in straight pool? You know, it's layouts like this. If you're always dealing with the balls wide open like this, you're going to run a lot of balls. And that's why it's so important to know exactly where you need to hit the rack to get the balls open and to find a good spot on that rack. I usually choose those corners. I stay away from the side of the stack. Here you see I got another really, really nice layout. None of the balls are touching. This is off of an ensuing break ball. And here, no secret to the way I play straight pool. I just like to get these balls down table. If I don't need them, I get rid of them. Came a little far for this one ball, but I'll be okay. I'm just going to come around two rails, try to line up on this two ball. Now, I like leaving that ball there, that two ball, because I like that's my key ball zone, and I don't like clearing out my key ball zone. But right here, I've got plenty of balls back here to get on my break ball, which I believe I'm going to choose that 11 ball, which is on the top right portion of the screen. In here, just get rid of these balls. Opt for a longer shot on that three, but that lines me up perfectly with this five ball. And watch what I do here. Let's come back over and around. I'm going to get that strike ball that's between, that's kind of in the middle there, that middle strike ball. There we go. Go ahead and tap this ball in. And right here, I got a perfect angle to go one rail and get parallel with my break ball. And every rack could be that simple when you get, but you have to get the balls open. That's the number one thing. And even though the break balls that I was showing were unorthodox, there are ways of getting the balls open. You're seeing me dropping the balls. I do that sometimes. But you know, running balls and getting into the rack and, you know, finding or having to create another break ball really takes a lot of work. And like I said, you're not always going to have an ideal break ball like this one. And see, that time I came off of that top ball. I still got a couple of problems within the rack area. But I've got some open shots here. And, you know, once again, you know, there's nothing major in this rack either. Just bear down, find your shots, see what balls belong and which balls do not belong on the table. And straight pool, like I said, is about getting the balls open and then getting them into the pockets. That's the name of the game. You can't do one without knowing how to do the other. And right here, you see me just kind of dealing with the few problem areas that I have on the table. And I believe if I get on this 15, I'll be okay.